You got to remember now they're going down 9,000 feet. On my land here, they're going out 6,000 more feet laterals on it. Drilling is noisy. Machinery is ongoing. Is it disruptive? Yes, it's disruptive for a short period of time compared to the life of the well. The life of these wells are average 25 to 50 years. Whenever you drill gas wells, it has to be transported some way. So consequently, it has to be done with a gas line. It is buried 8 foot deep on most places. It's covered back that we can farm over top of it. These guys want to leave that landowner happy when they leave. At least they want to make me happy. What's it like to live with a well once it's there? Like it is right now today, peaceful, quiet.
But fracking is controversial. Some chemicals used in the process can be health risks if they're released at the surface. And some people are concerned that if drilling isn't conducted properly, these chemicals or natural gas could be released into the groundwater.
They want to be concerned because after these well drillers are gone, we're still here. The residents are still here. We all want clean drinking water. We all need clean drinking water. It's a life resource for all of us. There isn't a day that there isn't DEP inspectors here, environmental inspectors here, to make sure everything is handled correctly.
This conversation is going on at the local level in a lot of these communities, and I think that's where it should be happening because it uses local knowledge and it harnesses the potential for community self-governance to determine what activities are done in their community and how they're done.
Because you're not only making decisions for today, you're making decisions that are going to last for years and years and years and down through generations.